And that's going to be from 7 to 10. Starting at 10 o'clock. Does everybody hear me? Starting at 10 o'clock. What are you doing?
I'm practicing for Saturday night.
Practicing for Saturday night? It's Tuesday night. Somebody that can do what?
Beat the bottles.
Beat the bottles? Who? What are you talking about? Who can beat the bottles?
That's a friend of mine right over here.
Where?
Up there.
Yeah, where? Is he up there? He can do what? Thank you. Jason Whirlybird right here with me. And I love this guy like a brother. And I just wanted to stand here and ask him a few questions for this tape. First of all, Jim, how does it feel to be back at Andy Teeks to play the bottles?
Oh, it is so nice. I'm having such a good time here today with all of the friends back from the olden days.
How's your dad Lawrence doing?
My dad Lawrence is doing very well. A one and a two and a one and a two. You know, all of the bubbles and all of that bulls.
He still has the 1, 2, 3 down.
And a 2, 3. A 1 and a 2 and a 3. Never got to pass the 30 grade, so that's all he can do. A 1 and a 2 and a 3.
Rumor has it, Jim, that you're really out in civilian life now and that basically you're an upstanding citizen, a pillar of the community.
That's very true. I am a pillar.
The type of fella that really and truly gets up and goes to work in the morning, comes home at night, has a wonderful family, and just living the life of a healthy, wealthy man.
That's very true. But boy, the broads here tonight are very nice.
Just goes to show you that being a healthy, wealthy family man is a normal thing to do that, right, Jim?
Oh, yes. I'm a gutsy, yes. A very nice lady. I like her better.
You like that lady right there?
I like that lady better right there, yes. And that lady right there, too. I fell in love 14 times in the last 10 minutes.
I think this could be 15 right here. And 16, and 17, and 18.
There's an old phrase about that low crawling over broken glass, you know?
In all honesty, Jim, tell the truth. Do you feel that you have a future playing bottles?
You know, at times I wonder if I have a future at all doing anything. I just want to get a paying job, you know what I mean?
Anybody you want to say hi to, Jim?
Hi, Mom. How are you? And I'd like to say hello to all my friends down at Antiques High School back there, the class of 72, and all my friends. Who's that little honey right there? I'd like to say hi to her, too.
That's the cameraman's wife, Jim.
Oh, hi. Yes. I'd like to say hello to all those people who have meant so much to me throughout the years.
True now that some Sundays you are still called to the pulpit.
Oh yes, my children. I was at the pulpit the other day and people asked me, they said, how do you, Reverend Jim, determine how the money that you collect is distributed? And I said, well, I take the altar and the offering when it comes in, and when the offering comes in, I have a big circle. And I say, like the Baptists, you know, they've got a 6-foot circle, and when they throw the collection plate into the air, what lands inside the circle goes to the church, and what is outside the circle goes to the ministry. I do the very same thing, except I throw the collection plate into the air, and I figure what God wants to keep, he will. Yeah. Really, they love it. Let me tell you about the special I got going, Jimmy. Not only do I have prayer cloths and blankets, I have the genuine imitation leather-bound copy, the King James Version of the Holy Bible with the words of Jesus written in red. I've got a special tonight. That's right. And if they'll send in 1995 for Reverend Jim right tonight, along with this genuine imitation leather-bound copy of the King James Version of the Holy Bible with the words of Jesus written in red, I will give them a life-size statue of Jesus that glows in the dark.
Well, Jim, I tell you, I'm just glad to know that you are being drawn back to the public, but I have one other question. I understand that your cousins down in Mexico.
Down in Mexico. My cousin Jose Jimenez Jimenez Torino the Terrible. Yes, he is still down there, and he is chasing all the women.
Chiquitas?
Still, and chiquitas, all the little chiquitas. It's very many little gringos running around, you know. Guy never could use birth control too good. Put it between his knees. Never worked so good. He is very similar to me. He's a slut. My cousin Torino is a slut. That's all about it.
Is there anybody else in your
to send a special hello to Durwood and Deerwood, my rich cousin, who has made such a success out of himself out of the free enterprise system. And I want to say that you too can be a millionaire. All you have to do is send $19.95 to Durwood Acres. Durwood Acres of Deerwood. Durwood of Deerwood. Just address him. He'll get it. And he will teach you how to be a millionaire. See, what he does is he gets all these people who send in money for the book. He makes it all the bank. If they don't cost him anything.
Durwood's a pretty sharp guy, Jim.
Sharp guy. He's cool. He drives a Mercedes.
Jim, I can't tell you how much I enjoy listening to your bottom play tonight. I'd like to hug your neck. Thanks, Jimbo.
Thanks tonight. He was incredible, like he was in the 70s. He's going to bring you back in the 80s. And Saturday night with the Jacksonville Symphony, the Whirlybird will set the whole town afire. Thank you, John.
An opportunity to see you. I've heard about you. Your reputation has preceded you for 7 years. You did a fabulous job. Really impressed.
Buddy?
He's the best bottle beater I've ever seen. No doubt about it. This is Mr. Octor.
Well, let me say that I believe that the reincarnation of Annie Teague's not only provides a gathering place for many, many of the local citizens who come to Jacksonville, but as well provides a place for community service. You see the folks doing Goldie Oldies nights out here. It's a chance for them to relive the days of their youth, as well as resurrect Captain Whirlybird, which is something that we've needed for the last 7 years. The town has missed very greatly, and we're delighted to have him back.
Body. The 43-year-old Simmons could be sentenced to jail, and there's no question he will be sentenced to
crash that caused three hit-and-run accidents, the death of one man, critical injuries to a small child, and ended as two cars crashed to a railroad track below. The chase began on I-95 near Myrtle Street about 4 o'clock this afternoon. The car, driven by 20-year-old Stephen Williams, rear-ended another car. When Williams left the scene, the driver gave chase through a quiet neighborhood below the highway, where Williams ran over a 4-month-old girl playing near the side of the road. Williams continued on to I-10 and caused another accident. This time, Williams and the other car crashed through a guardrail below. Williams' passenger, 53-year-old DeWitt Siggers, died at that crash. 4-month-old Carrie Powell is said to be in critical condition tonight at Wolfson's Children's Hospital. Williams is in satisfactory condition, under guard at University Hospital. Police say that he will be charged with driving under the influence. Traffic homicide detectives are still investigating. And in Arlington tonight, an accident involving a car and a motorcycle has taken the life of another Jacksonville resident. Police have not identified a man whose motorcycle crashed into the side of a car that turned in front of him. 47-year-old Hildreth Carpenter was turning into a shopping center off Atlantic Boulevard near Arlington Road. Police are charging her with failure to yield to the right-of-way and careless driving. Debbie?
Tonight, the investigation into a chemical spill on the north side is raising questions.